Hey everyone, this is Raja, Enterprise Agile Coach from ProXL Consulting. Now, let's move on to Agile. I'm going to give 7 reasons for moving on to Agile. May or may not be covering all the issues there, but somewhere or other those issues are covered in this 7 reasons. The first one, ambiguous requirements. This is the most common issue as we discussed earlier. Ambiguous requirements. See, most of these issues that we discussed earlier do come because of some assumptions we have in the traditional software development lifecycle. So if you go and question the assumption, probably those issues may not be there. So let's start with the assumption for ambiguous requirements. We assume customer can and shall identify all requirements in the beginning. Yeah, this is quite obvious, right? If you want a product to be developed, you should know what you want. And you should not only know just piece of what you want, you should know everything about what you want. That is an assumption, looks reasonable. So what we do? Ask customers what they want when they really don't know. At the starting of the project, it's not the right time for the customer to understand everything. Adding to that, what we do, we also ask them to sign off the requirements. We tell them to sign off the requirements. How many of your customers are comfortable signing off the requirements? And what happens when you ask the customer what they want when they really do not know, and if you are going to say later they are going to freeze the requirements and you cannot make any changes, what would be the reaction of the customer? Customer would think, okay, these guys are going to freeze the requirements end of this month. So what I will do, I'll give all the requirements I currently know. I may also give all the requirements I may not know because later I cannot add anything. So give all the requirements you think that should be there in the software. So customers may not know all the requirements in the beginning, that is given. No customer knows completely everything about the product at the time of starting of the project. They may not know. So the result is overproduction of features. Let's look at one of the very popular surveys by Standish Group. This group has come up with something called Chaos Report. This is very popular report, but this is a different report I am talking about. Standish Group did a survey very recently on, they studied various software applications and they studied what percentage of features are really used by the customers or the end users. The results were stunning. Starting with the first one, as per their study, only 7% of the features are always being used by the clients or the end users. And another 13% of the features are often used and sometimes used about 16% of the features. And interestingly, about 19% of the features are rarely used, but the most interesting part is this. About 45% of the features are never used by the users, end users. Or if you add this and this together, rarely and never, about 65% of the features are either rarely used or never used by the end users. Which means about 2/3 of the required features are either rarely used or never used. And only about 1/3 of the requirements are always used, often used, or sometimes used. Yeah, this may look strange to you, but let me give you an example. What is the most popular program or the software product you use? Say for example, Excel or Word. So do you know how many features are there in MS Word? Probably you may not know, but just estimate or give from your own experience, what percentage of features of MS Word do you use throughout your career so far? Probably in a single digit. If you are really a very experienced user of the word processing program, probably you would have used about 10%. I'm sure I have used much less than 7% of MS Word's feature. Take for example, Excel. Excel is like a mini database. How many of us used Excel to the complete capability of it? Very few. Probably it would fit to that 7%. So most of the software products have a lot of features which are rarely or never used. The reason could be this freezing the requirements in the beginning. Could be.